Let me say some things to you this morning. And this may help you in your study when you read the book of that's in this Bible, the books that's written here, Revelation. What does that really mean, Revelation? Is it something for you to get scared and run? No. What is Revelation? Or do you just think all of these is just something folks put together? These names, they really give you a start on really what you should expect in reading these books. Revelation. The revelation of Jesus Christ. A revelation means something that is disclosed. Something that was covered. Revelation actually means the pulling off the veil. For instance, if a person's in old times, they got married, they had the veil over their face. Some husbands didn't see their wives till they were married. Now, we still have the veil on our face, but we done seen some of everything. But the veil was taken off, and the husband saw his wife. Boy, that was some kind of godliness. Well, the husband knew what kind of wife he had by looking at the mom and dad. He knew the personality of the wife by looking at the mom and dad. The Bible says, as is the mother, so is her daughter. Scripture said, the son do what he see his father do. So they, when that veil was uncovered, and he saw her, and he, at this time, he has just got a revelation when that veil is taken off. He's just now able to see what was already there, but covered. Are hid. So why was it so important that Jesus Christ sent revelation to the church? Why did he do that? Most of us will jump over there in Revelation and we'll read things like about you might see war and you might see different events of killing on the earth and all these things that have come to pass. But the Bible says in the first chapter of Revelation, it says it like this, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to give unto his servant, things which must shortly come to pass. Now, can I get about four brethren up here real quick? In Revelation chapter 6, it talks about Chapter 5, it talks about one that was on the throne. And he had in his hand a book written and sealed on the backside. And no one could open that book or even read what was in that book because there was one sitting on the throne and from that throne went out lightnings and thunders and earthquakes. And there was fire coming out of the throne. That's why God was sitting right there in the midst of that. You must understand God is light. And in old time, light meant fire. The sun itself is fire. One scripture says our God is a consuming fire. It talks about when God descended upon the mountain, the whole mountain was in flame. Now, what you mess up is when you start trying to imagine stuff and not take the Bible at what it says. On that throne, there was him sitting there, and he had a book in his hand. Well, you might jot that down and read in Revelation 5 and 6. No man was able to go and get that book. Now, the Bible doesn't say what that book was, but according to how it's written, it kind of connotates that book was that he had in his hand was Revelation. Because that was the last book to be given to the church, was the book of Revelation. And you'll see why. As he sat on that throne, all of the angels cried and said, and wept. Nobody is able. And John said he saw it and he wept because no man in heaven or in earth was able to open the book, neither to look thereon or loose the seven seals. And one of the angels cried and said, don't you worry. The lion of the tribe of Judah, the offspring of David, he has prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. We got to understand, when God began to open up understanding to this word, you have got to have somebody that God has appointed to open up this book to you. Open it up. God's going to have that such a person. He said he's never left himself without a witness. So when that one sat on the throne and that lamb stood there that was slain, that was actually representing Jesus Christ. Nobody else could go and take that book. But that lamb of the tribe of Judah walked all the way up to that throne. Sit up on this stool, on here, preacher, if you don't mind. Right, sit on that top step. That lamb that had been slain turned around and walked to him that was sitting on that throne. Nobody could touch it. Nobody could come near it. Out of that throne was coming fire. But that was one that had redeemed man to God. He walked all the way up to that throne. And he took that book out of the hands of him that sat on the throne. I'm going to tell you something. When you can walk up to God and take somebody's hand, you better be clean. This book was sealed. What it was really illustrating, that was things that the church needed to know. They were in darkness. They needed a revelation. They needed the veil untaken off so they could understand what was predicament they were in and to understand the things that was going to come to pass in the earth. And only one had it was God. That's why it says the revelation. Now, once I got the book, and I start to understand, it becomes my revelation. When something that's been covered from you, you could not see or understand it, once the veil is taken off, once you start understanding what's here, that's your revelation. So this was the revelation. God gave it to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ gave it to his angel. And his angel turned around. He said, send it to the seven churches. Give me a few more brethren up here. Give me about seven of them. This is what happened. That's good. Come from God. God is wanting to reveal something to the church. He turns around and gives it to Christ. Christ gives it to his angel. And his angel gives it to his servant John. And when the angel comes to John, he comes there as he is Christ, but he's an angel. John even fell down to worship him later in the passage of Revelation. And the angel had to lift him up and said, I'm of your fellow servants, the prophets. He said, I fell down to worship the angel that showed me all these things. So the revelation came from God to Jesus. Jesus sent it by his angel to his servant John. So it was an angel that brought this message to John. And the angel told John, this is the angel. He's telling John, what I'm fixing to tell you, you write it in a book. And you send it to all of these pastors that's pastoring those churches. Send it to the seven angels over the seven churches in Asia. So God is giving a revelation to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ gives it to the angel. And the angel turns around and writes it down in a book so he can give it to all of these pastors. So all of these pastors can know something that they had not known. Pass it on down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.